Reverend Andriette, and this is Point of Power. So we are just embarking on March, which is Women's History Month. And so for Women's History Month, I'm going to begin our time today with a year of miracles. This is our Heart and Soul Center of Light annual read. So for 2020, we are going through the daily reading each day. And I have chosen for today to share with you day 61. And I'm highlighting and reminding you that this is Women's History Month because Marianne Williamson is asking us to take a stand, to specifically to take a stand for love. And it occurs to me that in Women's History Month, that I'm not sure that these United States has ever fully stood for women. Even the suffragettes, and this is not going to be about a history lesson, we're not standing for all women, unfortunately. And so I'm suggesting that we energetically, in our hearts, in our minds, in our politics, in our activism, in our awareness, that we stand for women, that we stand for humanity. Try that, that we stand for humanity in which women are included, and that we follow Marianne Williamson's suggestion for day 61, that we stand for love. She says very specifically here that it's important that I stand my ground today. And I have to tell you, as a daughter of political activists, that just, yes, today I stand my ground. I stand for wisdom. I stand for integrity. I stand for honesty. I stand for compassion. I stand for clarity. I stand for forgiveness. I stand for love. Those are Marianne Williamson's words, but they are just already written on my heart. And so I wanted to make sure that I shared them with you, that we may be together, that we may be inspired to stand and stand very clearly for humanity in integrity and wisdom and honesty and compassion, in clarity, in forgiveness for sure, and in love. She suggests that these not merely be words, but rather the field of our experience. That we gather all of our forces, and dare I say, our forces are numerous. We are empowered beyond belief. It is simply that we must center ourselves in the wisdom, the divine wisdom, the divine clarity to discern that our internal forces support us in leading the lives we were created to live. She ends this piece by asking, who am I to be lazy when I've been called by God to greatness? The answer to that question, the consideration of that inquiry is a point of power. Who are you to be lazy given that you've been called by God to greatness?